NGB. World TB Day is commemorated on March 24th of every year. എല്ലാ വർഷവും മാർച്ച് 24th നമ്മൾ വേൾഡ് ടി ബി ദിനമായി ആചരിക്കും. Why is this TB Day? Now it is just to raise awareness among the public and also a political awareness, because TB is a preventable and treatable disease. നമ്മൾ എല്ലാ വർഷവും ഇത് ഇങ്ങനെ ഒരു ദിവസം കൊണ്ടാടുന്നതിന്റെ ഉദ്ദേശം ഒരു പബ്ലിക് ആൻഡ് പൊളിറ്റിക്കൽ അവയർനെസ് കൊണ്ടുവരിക, ടി ബിയെ പറ്റി കൂടുതൽ ബോധവൽക്കരിക്കുക, ടി ബി എലിമിനേഷനെ പറ്റി ചിന്തിക്കുക. എന്തുകൊണ്ടാണ് മാർച്ച് 24? So it commemorates the day in 1882 when Professor Robert Koch announced the discovery of tuberculosis or TB bacillus. ആ ദിവസം ഓർമ്മപ്പെടുത്താൻ വേണ്ടിയാണ് നമ്മൾ വേൾഡ് ടി ബി ഡേ എല്ലാ വർഷവും കൊണ്ടാടുന്നത്. Now, there is 1.3 million deaths every year from tuberculosis, and it is mainly affecting the middle-income countries like India, Pakistan, etc. Now, every year we have a theme for World TB Day. In 2024, the theme is, Yes, We Can End TB. That is the theme of this year. Now, the global commitment by World Health Organization is to end tuberculosis by 2030. The government of India, with the National Tuberculosis Elimination Program, has announced to end tuberculosis by 2025. Now, TB mainly affects the lung. We call it as pulmonary tuberculosis, and it can affect any part of the body. ശ്വാസകോശത്തെ ബാധിക്കുന്നതിനെ പൾമണറി ടി ബി എന്ന് പറയും. ശ്വാസകോശമല്ലാത്ത ലിവറിനെയോ ബോണിനെയോ ലിംഫ് നോഡിനെയോ ബാധിക്കുന്നതിന് നമ്മൾ എക്സ്ട്രാ പൾമണറി ട്യൂബർക്യുലോസിസ് എന്ന് പറയും. How does TB spread? ഇത് മെയിൻ ആയിട്ട് പകരുന്നത് by sneezing, coughing and other droplet infection. നമ്മുടെ ഈ ലോകത്തില് 1/3 of the world population has an infection with tuberculosis. That we call it as latent tuberculosis or LTBI. അപ്പോൾ നമ്മുടെ ശ്വാസകോശത്തിൽ കയറുന്ന അണുക്കൾ അവിടെ കിടക്കുകയും പക്ഷെ അതൊരു രോഗാവസ്ഥയിലേക്ക് മാറാതിരിക്കുകയും ചെയ്യും. But 5-10% of this population will develop an active disease. That we call it as tuberculosis disease. അതിനെന്താണ് കാര്യം? Mainly it is due to malnutrition, diabetes, HIV, anti-TNF treatment, etc. These are the risk factors for developing latent TB into an active TB. Now, let us look into the roadmap for TB elimination. What are the problems that we face? Now, India, it's a country with a very high population. The rural-urban separations are not available. So, a mass screening for the whole population becomes a really difficult problem in a country like India. Now, most important thing is the emergence of what we call as multi-drug-resistant tuberculosis or MDR-TB. So, MDR-TB means many of the TB drugs are not acting against the TB bacillus, so you need newer drugs, new combinations, longer duration of treatment, which is a challenging problem in India now, which we call it as an MDR-TB. The most important thing is that there is a low budget allotment for the control of these diseases or elimination of these conditions. And of course, the most important thing would be the socio-economic status of the population. Now, we have this National Tuberculosis Elimination Program. So, we are moving at high pace because of the availability of tests like Manto test, X-rays, CT scans, and we have CB, NAT, TB, etc. So, is it all enough now? No. We need newer and newer tests easily available, like ISAT 6, CFP 10, like skin tests, so which is should be easily available so that large screening protocols can be planned. Now we are moving to a new technology called the Activate technology to detect MGB DNA in the blood. Of course, there are ways to detect the host immune response. So with the advent of these newer and newer technologies, we will be able to have a well controlled of tuberculosis. So I would like to conclude that we need a global TB elimination, but not just control. We need promising new vaccines, other than BCG vaccination. We need new diagnostic tests and treatment strategies. 142 years after first detection of TB bacillus, TB continues to cause disease in 10 million people annually. So the government must invest more into TB control effects and link them to WHO sustainable development goals. Reduce poverty, good housing facilities, correct malnutrition, and then we can say, yes, we can end TB. Thank you.